Hey.
We're sitting in the studio having this conversation about the fact that it's still so hard to believe that he's actually gone.
Yeah.
Like gone. Mm-hmm. Someone's going to say, "Bah, ta-da, I was joking. I'm here." Oh, it's not really going to happen, is it? Guys, we're so excited. We've got multi award winning actress Zola Nombona.
And she
can actually whistle properly. Like, whistle properly.
Of course.
Yo. Yeah.
Wait, because...
To
Yeah.
Mitata.
Yeah. So, yeah. Morning.
Oh, you're connecting the whistle. Exactly. Wait. Zola, thank you so much for joining us.
Wow. Thank you so much for having me,
We're excited
guys.
To have you on the show, man. It's 13 minutes past 7. What's your normal daily routine? What are you normally doing around this time if you're not doing interviews?
I've got a cute toddler.
Yes.
Who goes to school. So yeah. By now we are awake and getting ready for school, getting hugs and kisses and all those lovely things.
So you know when I heard that obviously we're going to be having you on the show, I think the first time I saw you on screen was Intersections.
Mm-hmm.
That was the first time.
Yeah.
Then obviously lockdown, Isono.
Mm-hmm.
Generations.
Mm-hmm.
And I know people love characters. Generations, guys. Pamela Cause.
Generations.
Okay.
Oh, homie.
Yes. Lockdown Monday. Isono Zoleka. I mean, obviously, you've told us where you were born.
Yeah.
Where did the dream to be in this space come from, if ever, or was it just by accident? How did you end up being here, coming from where you come from?
So growing up at Tinaskule, when the community and the children were still playing outside.
Yeah.
Yeah. Before the phones and Twitter and Instagram and all of those things.
Yeah.
So in my community, we practiced a lot. You know, since our graduation, so we were the entertainers as kids. You know, we loved it. So last week at school, we practiced dancing, practiced Sarafina. Obviously, I was. Thank you very much.
I
grew up in a very artistically supported space, and I think from there I knew about, okay, no, this is what I want to do.
From that age,
from a very young age I knew arts and culture at school. If there's anything that we have to do, trust you me, I will be in the front line.
You had this idea of what this thing is like, and now you are in the industry, right?
Yeah.
What is the biggest difference between what you perceive this thing to be versus the reality of actually being an actress in this industry? The reality now that you're in it.
Yo, I think the big difference, and when reality hit, was how volatile the space is. You know, you can be great today and you could be nothing tomorrow. So always remembering and always keeping the hunger and knowing, Ndoba, you won't always be at the top. And for you to stay at the top, you need to fight for it, number one.
Yeah.
You need to be authentic, number two. And you need to invest in the work itself and yourself, you know. So I think just how volatile the industry is something that I couldn't fathom at that age, but now that I'm in it, I'm like, oh shucks.
So how
okay.
do you as an actress invest in this craft?
Well, I think firstly, because we use ourselves as the vessels of the characters that we embody, I think it's taking care of your body, taking care of your mind, and just your general health, because it's one away, and it's like you can just hear your voice where you're like, okay, I can look a tip away, but if my voice sounds great and energized, it's fine.
Yeah.
But now you see the whole thing, from my voice to my physique to my face
to your skin
to my
hey,
tell them
I can see.
Let's go back to Matatiela.
Yeah.
Did you grow up with MT? Do you know MT?
Ah, Ilalika MT, I can actually see it from home.
Okay.
Yes, but Ukula na you know. But kuba singaba sematatela when I see him, like, yo, show him kaya.
Train,
yeah, no, salabanga sendi, ni chep.
So,
yeah.
When acting, are we kind of on the, like, you know, on these Joburg streets?
No.
You actually studied for it.
Yeah, I
How
did.
How do you think some of the people that don't really study for it and getting them a back door, how do you feel about those instances and what it does to the art?
Look, man, what's mine is mine. What's theirs is theirs, right? I would obviously always encourage someone to go the extra mile of, it's part of the investment we're speaking about, you know, of investing in your craft with learning who you are in the craft. What do you like? What don't you like? What can you do? What can't you do? I think training within the arts helps you understand that, and for your acting muscle or your performance muscle to be stronger, for you to see what you can do with it, for it to be malleable so that you can get in and out of all these characters that we do. Man, there's amazing what is it called, advantages that you get that you can't take away from anyone. The things that you can't take away from me.
Have you I don't know, have you ever sat down and thought about what an impact the show like Intersections made, you know, especially in South Africa? I remember the kind of content that they were dealing with back in those days.
How did you
land up on it? Am I right in that that's your first TV gig?
That was actually my first TV gig. So I was still studying at Wits University, and Kwapuma, what is it called? The open auditions, where the whole country was allowed to come and audition for this new show.
Yeah.
So we went with my friends and we warmed up outside. I think it was like 6:30 in the morning. We're already outside in the line to make sure that we are there. Warmed up, got in, did my thing, got to the screen test, and out of the whole country, it was 5 of us that were chosen for it. So that's how I got into Intersections.
And then the role, I mean, you play, like, if you look at, for example, let's go Intersections, right? Then you look at Lockdown. The roles that you played are so different, right? What was your most challenging?
Out of all the roles I've played, shucks, I actually think it could be the character I played on Hostel. I played
Hostel.
That was challenging. I've never embodied a role where this person just asks questions the whole time. Because she's a cop. That's what
you,
she does.
You have to interrogate, yes.
My whole role is to ask questions. Yes. Have you ever had to ask questions within colors and try to color how this question would sound? I think for me till date, that was the most challenging, man. You know, obviously all characters come with their own things, like Umonde, you know, with her being in jail and everything that she dealt with. Yeah. I feel like I had more connection to that. When it comes to being a cop, there was a bit of a work that I had to do because there was nothing in me that connected with her. And I think that's why it challenged me so much. I was like, okay, now I know what I can't do or what I struggled to do. I did it. I had to because I was in it. It was a great challenge, man. And I think it showed me that I haven't reached the glass ceiling. The stuff that will still challenge me, the stereotypes that I'm scared of, but I know that once I get into it, I'll learn something from it.
So we are live, as always, at Radio2000_ZA. You can watch it on Facebook. You can watch it on YouTube. We also go through your tweets, guys. Hashtag Timbaland Gang Gang. Hashtag The Takeoff. I already see the tweets coming through, so we'll go through as many of them as we possibly can. The actual real reason why she's here, guys, she's actually got a collaboration with the National Youth Service that she wants to talk about. So we'll talk about that at the end.
Okay, fine.
Okay. Because we're going to use this opportunity, right?
Okay.
We might even take calls. I don't know. Dineo will let me know with a wink or with a facial expression on 086-000-2479.
2023 is here. Get an insurance quote from MyWay and stand a chance of filling up for free by winning your share of 1 million rand in fuel vouchers. And get even more freedom by saving up to 25% when you add car, home or buildings to your insurance policy. The more you insure, the more you save. Call MyWay on 0860-64-64-64 and have a happy 2023. MyWay is a licensed non-life insurer and FSP. TCs and standard rates apply.
The GWMP Series Bucky is a Bucky of many firsts for South Africa. Step up to the load bin with the first tailgate step in a Bucky. Be aware of your surroundings with the first 360-degree camera system. Connect with the outside world through the first sunroof. Have peace of mind with the first semi-autonomous driving technology, heads-up display, and an extra center airbag. Experience a new world of firsts with the GWMP Series range of Buckies. Visit pseries.co.za now for special offers for the month of February.
So the world's 10 best cricket teams are in the country for the 2023 ICC Women's T20 World Cup. You can get your tickets on their website, which is t20worldcup.com/tickets, and turn it up at three of Mzansi's iconic stadiums for 23 action-packed matches, okay? And there'll be something for everyone, so bring the whole family. It kicked off from the 10th of February and it goes all the way until the 26th. We can't wait to see you there.
You're listening to the best breakfast show in the land.
Dombi, we are very excited to speak to you about today. It's a very important day. Why is it important to celebrate International Mother Language Day?
Just, you know, to place focus mainly really on indigenous languages. And as you know, that there's many languages that are actually dying out. So it's very important that we really highlight days such as this, just so people are aware that there actually has to be an intentional preservation of their languages.
There are people that were born in this country that can't speak any other language besides English, and they've never ever tried to learn. All they know is Sabona. Where do you think we got it wrong, and how do we fix it?
Sabona. You know what? So there's what the Department of Basic Education is, what you call it, the incremental introduction of African languages in schools, right? And this was actually to address this very thing that you're talking about.
So what do you want to say to black parents who have kids who can't speak their home language, where Gyakwetuiza in the mall? Because it's always weird when I watch it, where it's two black parents. But anyway, yes, just to encourage guys, because also we come from a system where we thought that was the thing to do.
You see, that's why days like this are important, just to remind ourselves, because we associated English with resources.
There is Ntombe Enhle Hulu-Hulu, who's the spokesperson for the PEN South African Language Board. I don't know, when she spoke about us being kids, I thought about Utu Taitewa Etegwini
Kibeli Hashi. I win. Yes, yeah, well, yes, Kubeka.
Hashtag The Takeoff at Radio 2000 ZA on all social media platforms. Be part of an award-winning team.
Officially the most streamed African-born artist in history
for
of
real?
Music. History of music.
I mean...
I know, right? That's what I thought.
Like, come on.
But also, like, let's be honest. He's always had the daddy muscle power and the bad boy. Mm. And he's American. He's African, but he's American.
All right, so Cape Town is turning it up for the 2023 ICC Women's T20 World Cup. And it's been a while, but our time has finally come again for us to host another world-class World Cup like the African way. So get your tickets from t20worldcup.com/tickets. Let's turn it up with passion, turn up the volume, and watch 12 action-packed matches at Newlands. You don't want to miss this. So please go to t20worldcup.com/tickets for more info.
So you chose Famous, right?
Yes.
This song. Why the song?
I think it's the lyrics. When I think of the song, I think of my son, actually. I think it's a song that I dedicated to my son. As much as he is born
Famous.
With... Well, if you want to put it like that, okay.
Yeah.
Now that he's born famous, I don't know, there's a part of me as a mother who's just like, oh my gosh, I really hope you don't get famous, baby.
Does fame add extra pressure to relationships? Obviously, you're married to Thomas Kumete, right?
Uh-huh.
People know Thomas. He's also... a big head in the industry mm-hmm. in its own right, and yes, obviously you're also. So does it add extra pressure? Because like, I know him from out,
yeah,
right, where
yeah,
you meet him.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't really know him, but I think I know him because yeah. I know. I also think I know you, but I also don't know you. Yeah. Does that add extra pressure?
I guess it does, but then it also depends on the person that you're with. You know, Thomas and I believe we are quite grounded people. And we've never let our popularity or our celebritydom to get into our heads and our hearts, you know, and let it affect the core of who we are. Mm-hmm. So being with someone who's that grounded, someone who is that humble, I think it makes us a better duo, you know, with not allowing those pressures to crack the safety of our relationship.
What did he do for Valentine's Day? Or did you he's convinced you that it's not important this
time? I know, definitely from day one. He was like, I'm on a Valentine, you know, yes,
literally. But I'm curious, who calls who to order between the two of you?
I think I'm the crazy one, so I guess he does. Okay. Yeah, I think our relationship came at a great time when he had somewhat outgrown the young famous and in a bambi right. Yeah, okay. Now that he's ready to step up, that's when I caught him at the right time. So yeah,
that's
I think
what he thinks about you. He's like, yo, nam fumana grand.
Exactly, maybe that's what he thinks, but now it's a night chance. And he's the one who needs to come back and say, hey, it's all about slow down.
Yeah. But is it not difficult to wait your turn when it comes to casting? Because obviously he casts people,
yeah.
He's got influence on who can get with roles.
Uh-huh.
There's times where I'm like, hey, chita, why
I think a lot of people actually ask that.
Do you not get that?
So fortunately, I myself understand the industry, you know,
yeah.
and I never want to put my partner in a situation like that, which, okay, whatever you do, I need to be part of it.
No. Yeah, oh, I see.
Man getting married, is there a role there that suits me? Mm-hmm. Did I audition well? And was the channel happy, you know? So it's understanding all those things and not saying, oh, I shame him to and gains an impact and no pressure.
Fair opportunity.
Yeah, man, must be fair on everyone.
You're better than me. If my person was the person, gang jalani, I mean.
But it's tough, dog. Sometimes you look at a show and you're like, oh, man. But you know, just understanding
morning
the intricacies
of it. Morning, Jimmy. I don't get a little bit. I always say, Piazza. And I don't the character to hire while you lie.
Oh,
talk
nice.
Moto. Motong or Gerne, keep up the good work. We love you on screen.
Thank you.
I hope man, she scoops the awards next time.
Oh, that is so sweet.
So we were having a funny conversation with Lonabo earlier on about teasing kids at school, right? Especially
mm-hmm.
especially with the gap.
Mm.
I remember in the soccer field, there was this. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Because. So we used to say, like, you know, when we're playing soccer, Ipal.
Yeah.
Said, no, don't worry, just go stand there, we'll score the ball between your teeth.
At least.
Were you teased about your gap?
Of course.
And, when did you grow? Because I find now it's so sexy. But back then it wasn't.
Yeah, it wasn't.
Yeah.
Trust me, there were times where I didn't like it. All about 5 rand or 5 cents. Yeah, you can fit 5 rand there. All the lies just spew so easily out of your mouth through the gap. You know, I guess because we all have them at home, and I've seen how beautiful my sisters look with their gaps. I mean, it'll come a time where I'll grow into it.
Yeah. I feel like now it's like a beauty spot. Oh, why don't I have a gap?
But
like
I know. Manje, look at me now. Where are the 5 rands now? They're coming in. They're coming in.
Listen, man, I see the tweets. We haven't forgotten about you. Hashtag Timbaland Gang Gang on Twitter. We'll go through all of your tweets on the other side. We'll also talk endorsements and social media fame.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Versus the traditional fame. Is that the right word?
Nice.
She's got it both.
Yeah, yeah. And it's rare to have both, actually. So we'll have that conversation next.
News headlines at 7:30 on Radio 2000. I am Onde Lambana and a very good morning. The Center for Entrepreneurship and Innovation at the University of the Western Cape says it hopes that the Finance Minister, Enoch Godongwana, will make provision for small, medium and micro enterprises when he delivers his budget speech this afternoon. The EFF leader, Julius Malema, has dismissed concerns that the party's planned national shutdown next month may plunge the country into further economic crisis. And the Freedom Front Plus member of the Free State Legislature, Armand Kloet, says the Premier, Sisi Ntombela, had no choice but to resign because she was between a rock and a hard place. A full update follows at the top of the hour.
Get it first on your mobile, on the web, and on your dial. This is Radio 2000 Sport.
Good morning in your sport. South Africa will play England in the Women's T20 World Cup semi-final after a 10-wicket win against Bangladesh. Laura Wolfart hit an unbeaten 66 from 56 balls as a nervy Proteas side made hard work chasing down a modest target of 114 with 13 balls to spare. So it means that South Africa finished second in Group 1 behind holders Australia, who face India in the other semi-final. Captain Nigar Sultana Jotty earlier top scored with 30 from 34 as Bangladesh trundled to 113 for 6. It was so good to see. Well, I couldn't see it because I had load shedding, but when I went back to social media, it was fantastic. No, it is the case. I couldn't watch
you
anything.
You thought about
yesterday.
It. Imagine
I couldn't watch the cricket. I couldn't watch the football.
It's so the thought that counts.
I'm as next this morning, actually. But yeah, as I went back on social media, I saw Newland Stadium looked colourful with everyone watching women's cricket. Let's continue to support the women's Proteas as they embark on this journey. We don't know when another World Cup is going to come to South Africa, the cricket one especially. In football now, another side that is lovely to see flourishing, Hilda Magaia's long-range strike on 77 minutes has earned Banyana Banyana a 1-1 draw with Slovenia in their second game at the Turkish Women's Cup yesterday. Here's Coach Desiree Ellis speaking on their performance.
We knew the game was going to be tougher. We watched the game before, but I felt we conceded poorly. You know, we spoke about the danger of the wingers, and we conceded poorly. And I thought, they had a lot of possession, but at times they played in front of us, and I thought we handled that well. We changed the formation slightly to give us a little bit more numbers in the midfield, and we could have wrapped it up after.
In another clash that I couldn't watch, Liverpool were sensationally beaten 5-2 by Real Madrid despite being 2 goals up early in the Champions League round of 16 first leg at Anfield. Something to look forward to today. Leipzig head coach Marco Rosas has called on his players to show courage when they take on Manchester City in tonight's first leg of the Champions League last 16 tie at the Red Bull Arena, but also enjoy themselves against one of the best teams in the world right now. Rose conceded that Pep Guardiola's City pose a threat from all directions, but he did single out Erling Haaland, who he coached at Borussia Dortmund, for special praise.
His mentality, if he sees a goal, he's getting crazy about scoring, and he's always there for the team, he's working for the team. Improved a lot, and his game, his technical side, and the movement, things around, and now he's playing for one of the best teams in the world.
So these fixtures will kick off at 10 o'clock this evening. In rugby now, shock centre Rohan Jansen van Rensburg admits that fullback Apele Lefasi's injury is a setback ahead of Saturday's rugby championship match against Ulster in Durban. The Springboks sustained a rib injury in the Sharks' win over the Lions last weekend and will be out for at least a week.
Yeah, Apele is an unbelievable player, like everyone here knows. It will be a massive loss for us, but I do think there's some players potentially coming back this week, which we have to see who it might be. But I think we have some quality players that's willing to play this weekend, or coming out of injury, or maybe even stepping up into the role. I feel like the player that's going to go there is definitely going to fill the boots that Apuleria has there. The counter-attack is still going to be live and ready when we play on Saturday.
Final sport headlines at 8 for Radio 2000 Sport. I am Lonwa Bongotla.
We play more local music than the law allows. Radio 2000. Radio 2000. Feel good music. Radio 2000.
So it's your song, right?
Yes, it is.
What is it?
La Don.
Why?
There's something. So how about I listen to music, right? I listen to beats first before lyrics. So this is one of those songs where, come on, show me, yes. Bring it. So it's just enjoying the beats of the song. There's a
the reason I asked you why. These are the songs that DJs listen to. Like when you listen to music, you're like, yo, now I can come in. And I'm like, I didn't expect this.
Yeah.
You've surprised us with your music selection.
Come on, confirm.
No, you know this thing. So it's cool. We get it. Listen, we're gonna go through more of your WhatsApps on 0605842250. And then we are going to wrap with the collaboration with the National Youth Service, which is super exciting. That's all gonna happen before 8 o'clock on the show.
On air. Online and on your mobile. This is Radio 2000 Traffic.
At ShopRite, we're committed to bringing you the best value. Swipe and save with our Essentials Combo Deal that includes 18 large eggs, a 6-pack of 100-gram Parmalat yogurts, 700-grams Sasco brown bread, 750-grams Champion French bologna, a 500-gram brick of Delight, and 150-grams Crystal Valley cheese slices. All six for 99 Rand. Only 3 deals per customer. Valid until 12 March 2023. Only at ShopRite. Get a quote from MyWay and stand a chance to win your share of 1 million Rand in fuel vouchers. Visit myway.co.za for details and have a happy 2023. MyWay is a licensed non-life insurer, FSP. T's and C's apply.
On air, online, and on your mobile. This is Radio 2000 Traffic.
Good morning. If you're driving in from the Vaal towards Joburg, the R59 remains heavily backed up. It is a busy route, but this morning the queue is extending from Swartkoppies Road all the way through to the Reading Interchange. There has been a collision at the top end of that 59, which is causing that backlog. At the N12 in from Lanesia and Protea Glen, still queuing up towards the Golden Highway exit. Make sure you got extra time to get through that one. No lights on Olifantsfontein Pretoria Main Road in Midrand, that side of Midrand, the eastern side of the highway, heavily congested. And coming across from sort of Blue Hill, Savannah Hills area on Olifantsfontein's heavy. Load shedding, Monument Park and Erasmus Kloof, always worth a mention because it is absolutely jam-packed. At Durban, some load shedding in the Newlands area causing delays on Inunda Road towards the N2. A crash on the M4 Southern Freeway near the M7. A very heavy Durban bound coming through from Jacobs and Clarewood. And here's the big one. If you're Durban side, there's been a collision halfway down Fields Hill, the M13, going into Pinetown. Traffic on the M13 is heavy all the way back into Hillcrest, and then local routes through Kloof are either a jam trying to avoid Fields Hill by going Wybank Road, or jam up trying to get out of Kloof and into that M13 mess. Cape Town, Bosman's Dam Road also a mess this morning from Edgemead down towards the N7. The N7 north to get off is queuing heavily from Goodwood southbound. Backlog of traffic there as far back as Dunoon. The M5 slow this morning, Kenilworth up towards the N2. And if you're driving Baden Powell Drive through Kyalich, no traffic lights at the N2, so delays if you're trying to get across towards the Easter Rafia and Stellenbosch side.
Stay in touch with us. Twitter at Radio2000_ZA.
Morning, 2000 gang gang. First time, what's up? Ish, my crush, Monday. Ish, I'm thinking I'm Chinese.
Good morning, 2 million gang gang. Hope you're good, guys. Hope you're great, Bongani. The girls, open the grand, Majita. Usis, love, usis, Zola. Yeah. Yes, my fetch, yes, man, yo. Yeah, Shem, your boss, yes, yes. I remember on one of her interviews, Ansaz Wakup, or was it Zaziwa or something like that, she mentioned what she's singing.
Yes.
Bro, I drove, yo, everywhere, like out in Gaslangan and Icon, I'm sent in, yo. Yo, you know, Auckland Park, wherever, like nothing, Gambona corner, just ask her out. So, chigi, nah, gulumfana. Thomas.
I knew it.
Kithi lomfana njengoba ihlanyela nje lo sisi wenzani ngalomfana. Yo, kanti the guy is serious. Ah. Sengilahlela ithawuli manje.
Oh.
Morning. Million again. Sihle lwaphe umthatha.
Morning,
Sihle. Uzola ndiyamazi. Was around here.
Okay.
So she doesn't know me that well because age difference.
Oh.
I go to church in Vodadak. I know her brother.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, ours is not.
But...
Supports her all. We always got her back.
Oh, keep props up.
And speaking of back home, I guess, and that fame, so right? Obviously, yep. You leave home to go study. You mm-hmm. studied. Now you're TV.
Mm-hmm.
And I know if you're coming, especially from places outside of Joburg.
Yeah.
Being on TV and these things are a big deal. I know everyone acts like they're not, but they're a big deal. People have seen you. Do you remember going back home and the fame and how people treat you differently? Were you able to observe the thing?
I was. Ngo, because I figured about the 18 Ngo.
To your house, ne?
Yeah, to want to come take pictures. But I think Ngo, because sebe kunqelaga kancinci, you know,
okay.
Starting to get used to the idea. When they see me, it's just like, ah,
it's normal.
You keep the... Keep up the good work, you know. But at first, I don't want to lie. I loved it. I absolutely gobbled all of that energy.
What about
up.
Now? Privacy, scrutiny, children. Kids, marriage. I'm imagining a simple thing like, you know, sometimes, guys, you want to hold your person's hand and walk in the mall.
Yeah.
And not have some benning some twin. You don't want to speak to anyone. How do you find that fame now?
Look, in this, I turned it, to be honest, right?
Yeah.
I think... I keep on appreciating as I grow the love that I get from people because it shows the impact that I have within my career and all the stories that I'm telling, you know. So for me, that love is something that I don't think I'll ever get completely tired of, you know.
Yeah.
But kubandingumntunam, there are instances and times where I'm just like, oh my goodness.
I don't feel like taking a picture.
Yeah, not today. But I do it because I understand how it feels to see someone that you really admire. You know, and kasombona face to face, when would you see them again?
You know
what I'm saying? So I do try my best to be as kind and to be as gracious as I can, whether I'm in a good mood or not. I guess it comes with the territory.
And speaking of territory, I mean, you're running the social media space, right?
So
you're on Twitter, Marvin's Uti. I wanted to listen to the show to know who the lady you're talking to and you're hosting. If you just go to Zet Nombola on Instagram, you will know exactly who we're speaking about. But I mean, they usually say that when you get married as an artist or just like a popular person, iyaphela yonke into.
Yeah,
it's career suicide. A lot of it's always been the perception, and there's people that we can see.
They say that it's career suicide.
I thought actually having a child would be career suicide until I got into it and I realized that it gave me. Just superpower of sorts when I get into it. And like I said, I'm fortunate to be with someone who's also in the industry, with someone who understands all these things and knows that, okay, cool, it's your time to shine, or you know when to pull you back, or when to support you and get home and cry and say, someone said something mean on Twitter, or someone said this to me, and he'll be the one to hold me and or melezing his closer, you know. So I guess for me, getting into relationships or marriage, and having a child are things that actually gave me a stronger backbone, and more depth within the industry.
There's a love-hate relationship between social media fame, because before it was separate. Before social media came, there were social media stars, then there were TV stars.
Yeah.
And I'm finding that the new stars, which are you guys, are finding the proper synergy between the two, between
both
being
stars.
Both, right? like, what is your take on social media influencing into these spaces, whether the people go from there to being an actor, to being a TV presenter, etc.?
Sharks, man. Look, I guess it comes with its own benefits, right? Because people that are social media famous, people feel like they know them better because I saw you doing your own thing.
Relatability.
You know? Yeah, you're more relatable. They're like, okay, no, yakava wena, because I see you, this is what you drink or whatever. Whereas when you're on screen, you are playing someone else. And then people don't get a chance to possibly see who you are first, you know, but they see that character and then when we celebrate. So I could say they're celebrities and then social media famous people are famous.
You spoke.
And you are?
Both.
Yeah, you know, I dip here and there.
You're also popular and not famous, and I'm trying to understand what the difference is.
I heard her speaking about, you know, people seeing you drink. I saw one of your stories, you were drinking that drink that you put on your head. I thought you were going to bring something to the
I just have 0%. I don't worry, I'll come through. I will come through.
Can you 0%?
Yeah.
No, we're not playing games here.
It's still the same dry, crisp taste, baby.
But it doesn't give you the...
But you can still put it on your head and it gives you everything.
Yeah, we don't put this one in our head, please. Yeah.
Listen, we're going to pay bills. We'll play more of your voice notes. We'll talk collaborations, brand endorsements, and then, of course, we'll talk about the important thing, which is the National Youth Service. We have different languages and cultures, but what we have in common is that we all want a dignified funeral and for our loved ones not to worry about money when the time comes. Trust Clientele to provide you with affordable funeral cover that will pay out within 24 hours. SMS Radio 2000 to 49708. That's Radio 2000 to 49708. SMS now. Clientele Life is a licensed life insurer and an authorized FSP. Standard rates, terms, and conditions apply.
Hey, buddy, it's me, your car. Well, we've been through a lot over the years, eh? Many roads, many towns, so many memories. But listen, it's time to move on, eh? Go and get yourself a fresh new ride. But just promise me one thing. Let me go the right way. Let me go to We Buy Cars. We Buy Cars, the best way to sell your car by far.
Simonstown, we've got you covered on 97.2 FM. Feel good music.
Heavenly Father, I'm truly thankful for the love, the knowledge, the wisdom, and the courage. Hallowed be the name, glory to the King for keeping my soul so safe. God has a plan for every human or animal living on the earth. Life, great gifts God gave was a gift to create life. For me, never before, local Tando Laco, no woman telling us if one is so sucko. Intrusive yam, yoki pillow yam, Mrs. Antennis of Taliwam. Intrusive yam, yoki pillow yam, Mrs. Antennis of Taliwam. Hey, he's taking me to church.
Good morning to Mita Gang Gang. Mzolisto. Yes, I worked with her. I was an art director on the night. Yo, the girl, she has it. She has it all. Good luck, Zolisto. Hey, Tarasu.
Thank you.
Morning, Gang Gang. I was Zolo Yabulala. Who has no Thomas Kume? That's why I'm Bambi the first. Then I'm shut down there. But besides that, she's a great actor. Craft is polished. Keep on doing the good job, my sister.
We've got him, Zolisto.
Hey, dude. Hey.
That's my dad's name. So there's a connection. There.
Really? Powerful Zola. People, John. Powerful no, people. Zola. Powerful people.
Your dad's name is
Zola.
Oh, that's such a cool album, Zola. Endorsements, you know. I find, obviously, because you're in the social media space.
Yeah.
That's where big money comes in. Mm-hmm. You worked with an iconic brand, which mm-hmm. we all grew up with, the Lele Ngubo. How excited mm-hmm. were you to work with such a... I mean, you know, there are things that I think most people don't think. I'm sure back home you never thought that would ever happen.
Ever.
Right?
Ever.
How did that collaboration happen? It's a big deal.
Dog, it's a huge one. I'm actually the first ambassador for this brand.
No, you can mention
the brand. Oh, thank you. I'm the Fashini ambassador. Yes.
You did.
Well done. You know.
Yo, it so I got into brand management, to the Max brand management, and Dan was absolutely amazing. You know, sit with her, we dream with her, and she is the Zola 7.
She's a beast in this thing, right?
She is a beast. All you need to do is to work hard, make sure that you focus, tell her what your dreams are. Then you're gone.
Congratulations.
Thank you, my king.
It's such a big deal.
Yeah, Bulel.
Now let's talk about serious things, right? Collaboration with the National Youth Service.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, so here's the thing, right? Uzola, we are cooler, right? I acted, you know, got into a serious relationship, and then got into the family space, and I could feel that I can do more.
Yeah.
You know, I've gotten all this popularity / fame, and what else can I do with it? You know, how can I impact Abantu and the world and just my orbit? How can I impact it in a positive way for the future? Because now I've got a child, you know, and I want to see South Africa becoming a better place, and understanding that I'm still the youth, and youth employment is something that is absolutely terrible in the country. So I got this opportunity to work with the NYDA with a project here, the National Youth Service project, and we're doing a docuseries where we're speaking to 21 beneficiaries that got support from the NYDA and the NYS project. It's a wonderful project, man, to see the amazing work that our government also tries to do, you know.
Yeah.
This project has helped close to over 45,000 young people, you know, in the country. People don't know about this. So I was very fortunate to have the opportunity to go and meet them, to go and see what actually the NYS is doing. And it's benefits that I think you can't even touch it, you know.
Yeah.
It's those type of benefits that you see. Life-changing benefits, man. Abantu be cool, like people gaining skills, you know, people supporting their own, people serving their communities. You know, you'd never think that you can grow from serving other people. You always think that you need to invest in yourself first. You must always receive first.
Yeah.
But meeting people that believe in serving their communities and their people, and seeing how much that they do actually gain from it, you know, is wonderful. And I can't wait for people to watch the docuseries.
Power couple collaboration with you and hubby, international career.
Okay, so obviously my man's is co-owner of a lovely production company that has been doing really great I'm learning a lot from him, you know, and I think there's space for me as well to grow behind the scenes, you know, because I see what he does and I'm just like, yo man, I think I can actually do this as well. So I think growing as a producer, as a writer, possibly a director as well, the things that I'm looking forward to.
You know, getting to a woman can convince men to do anything, whether it's through the belly, whether it's through other means.
Yeah.
When you get home, please convince hubby. I know Sebe Kulile Manj. Him,
Season 4.
Scoop. They owe us.
Even me, I also want one. I also would love to get some support from the guys, man.
And also, please, can you put it on other platforms? I even went on YouTube to try and get episodes to rewatch the thing.
Is it?
Because as I got older, I was like, guys, this thing was so important for us growing up.
Yeah.
To see and young black kids doing cool things and being responsible.
It's so cool, actually, because I also find a great correlation with the NYS project as well, you know, because those guys were young guys.
Yes.
Who were just like, actually, we're going to do this ourselves, you know.
And they did it.
And I think it influenced and showed us, as well as the youth, that we don't need to only go for traditional careers, you know, for us to get that fire in us to keep on burning, you know. So also seeing what the boys did is something that is still encouraging till date, you know, for young people as well, to say it doesn't only have to be in accounting, you know. You like sports, sharp, agriculture, sharp, something. Yeah. And the NYS hashtag I'm proud to serve series is something that does that for young people as well, to keep them encouraged to say that as much as kunzi mufumana umsebenzi in South Africa, there are many other avenues that we can still stretch ourselves into. There's no need for you to always be famous. There's no need for everyone to want to get, you know, to be successful. No, dog. Serve your community, dog. Allah with what you have within your community, and you can grow from there.
Social media, if I'm interested, where do I find find you? Because I saw that you've got there and there's a link as well on your stories. Where do we find you on social media?
On Twitter, it is at Zola Nombona. On Instagram, at ZNombona.
And Jens was on Blocker with his comments in, please.
Ah, this is on Blocker. I'm going to keep them coming.
And I was saying, you are so amazing in person.
Thank you.
I don't even know you that much on social media, and I'm glad I don't, because this is the Zola that I wanted to know.
Okay. No, thanks for
I'm
coming.
I'm glad.
Man.
Thank you so much for having me.
Now you can carry on with the rest of your day.
I want to stay.
Guys, it's 8 o'clock. It is news. By the way, you can go and watch the whole thing. It's still going to be live on YouTube at Radio 2000_ZA. That's where you can get all the details. You can also go and watch it now on Facebook. So the video stays on Facebook for as long as, I don't know how long, but it's always there. So it's news at the top of the hour, and up to 5 million rand life cover with no medicals or blood tests required for qualifying clients at our insurance, okay? You need to SMS the word cover to 31126.
SABC News, independent and impartial.
In news at 8, Small Business speaks on budget speech expectations, and FF Plus reacts to Ndombela's resignation.